In this first video, we're going to start with a review of MATLAB and Simulink, and then quickly talk about what is the MATLAB Aerospace Toolbox. All right, welcome to a new video series on the MATLAB Aerospace Toolbox. With the rise in popularity of MATLAB in the engineering community, this video series is going to help you take your MATLAB skills to the next level as an aerospace engineer. Now, if you're an aerospace engineer or want to be an aerospace engineer and take your skills to the next level, subscribe to the channel. This is a channel dedicated to aerospace engineering, education, and software. Let's get to it.
So before we take a look at what the MATLAB Aerospace Toolbox is, let's have a quick review on what MATLAB is. MATLAB is actually short for Matrix Laboratory. The creator of MATLAB was actually trying to find a way for students to be able to do linear algebra without having to use Fortran. So we got to start with manipulating and storing matrices. Now, if you ask people what MATLAB is, they might have different answers and it might be hard to explain. Some people might say, oh, it's just an expensive programmable calculator on your computer. Other people might say that it's a computer language. Some people might just say that it's a data analysis software, but I really like the Wikipedia definition. I know in school Wikipedia is not a good source. However, when it comes to describing MATLAB, I think it has a very good definition. It says that MATLAB is a numerical computing environment and proprietary programming language. And it gets that definition because MATLAB is often used for doing data analysis, for doing simulation, and of course for doing post-processing data, which often involves plotting. Now there are some alternatives to MATLAB, right? You have Mathematica, Solver, Maple, Octave, Scilab, and FreeMap. Now Octave is special because anytime that it has an issue where what you create in Octave can't work on MATLAB, it treats it as a bug. It's all about being compatible with MATLAB. So here on the right, I have a typical layout of the MATLAB environment. On the left, you have some file folder operations. On the right, you'll have your workspace. This is where you can look at your variables and manipulate them. In the middle on the bottom is the command window. So that's where you can do some command line prompt commands. And then, of course, you also have the option of writing code, scripts, functions, libraries, classes, objects. And so there in the middle on the top, you might see a code editor. Now, a lot of times when talking about MATLAB, you're going to hear about something else that's called Simulink. This is another product by the same company that makes MATLAB. Simulink is a graphical programming environment. So you are doing a lot of your modeling and simulation in a graphical type format where you're dealing with blocks and connecting signal lines. And it's actually really great at doing dynamic modeling of multi-domain systems. Now here on the right, I took a screenshot of what a model might look like in Simulink. You know, you have your different subsystems there and it got lines connecting what signals need to go to what blocks. Now there is a Simulink Aerospace block set, and that Simulink Aerospace block set does rely a lot on this MATLAB Aerospace Toolbox. However, I'm going to go ahead and separate the two, and in this series, we're going to look at the MATLAB Aerospace Toolbox, and I'll have a separate series for the Simulink Aerospace block set. So the main question of the video is, what is the MATLAB Aerospace Toolbox? The toolbox is actually an add-on that you can purchase for your MATLAB environment. Now you might check with your school. Sometimes they'll have it available for you. Or if you're trying to buy your own student version at home, you might want to go ahead and pay the extra $10, $20, $30 or whatever it is to get this if you're an aerospace engineer. So what in the world is this add-on to MATLAB? Well, I like to break it up into basically it's two things. The first thing is that it is a lot of pre-written code available to you to use. The second is that it offers some visualization tools for you. So you can visualize the aircraft in flight, either looking at the aircraft or looking at the instrumentation. And you have a couple different options for how you actually animate this aircraft, not just in terms of looking at the real world test data versus doing a simulated flight, but also in terms of the different tools that are used to actually do the animating. And in this series, we'll have different tutorials to show you the different ways to animate the aircraft. Now, going back to some of that pre-written code, some of that code is very useful because it means you don't have to go and write this code. But a lot of it follows certain standards or references so that if you know what reference you're supposed to be using, you might already have something written up and available for you. So you'll be able to get your simulation or your analysis of an aircraft design up and running that much quicker because it's saving you time having to write all these different codes for environmental models or doing a coordinate transformation from one coordinate frame to another. These tools are written around simulating an aircraft design to be able to look at its stability and control and its performance. Now, at this time, the toolbox does not actually look at the stability and control derivatives or coefficients of an aircraft design. You normally have to specify those when you're grading your model, or it does have a nice feature where you can import the DATCOM coefficients into the model. So basically what you're able to do is you're able to take these stability and control derivatives and aero coefficients. You're able to choose different environmental models at different coordinate frames, and you're able to simulate the motion of the aircraft due to this flow of air around it and be able to look at how it performs in that environment. Now, the reason we do this, of course, is so that we can analyze a design and determine, is this going to work? Do I need to maybe redesign something about this aircraft? Is the flight control system going to be able to control this? And so the MATLAB Aerospace Toolbox is actually there to help you get this simulation up and running quicker. And it's also there to help you do some analysis and visualization of the sim when you get it up and running. Now, there are some additional toolboxes that you can get that add on to this Aerospace Toolbox. We might talk about those in a future video. And then another cool thing is that you can, if you've recorded flight data, you can import that into MATLAB and run it through your simulation and see how the simulation compares to your actual real-world flight data. And on the right of the screen, when you see that aircraft and you see two of them bouncing around, that's looking at the difference between looking at the real-world flight data and a simulation. We'll go over a lot of the different pre-written code, and then we'll probably run through some tutorials to show you how to simulate the flight and look at the aircraft's performance and visualize it, either right there using the airplane or maybe using some of the instrumentation.
All right, we're going to go ahead and end the video here at the start of a new series. I don't know about you guys, but I sure am excited for this series. I'll see you in the next video.